I'm Lord Arman, guitarist and founder of Dark Funeral, and we have a new album out called Atera Totus Sanctus. For every album we have written, it have felt like, you know, very complete. But, you know, I guess, you know, new inspiration comes in, you know, new things piss you off, and, you know, will always be new music come out from us, and I think we learned lots of new things on the new record, both in writing and, you know, twist and turn things in a little bit different ways than we have done before. And I think, you know, we can work a little bit more on those new inputs on future records. Oh yeah, it's more complex on this record. It's more, it's for sure the most technical album we've done so far. Of course, you can still hear it's Dark Funeral, but the speed factor obviously required that you, you know, have to improve your skills a little bit. I think you learn a lot of new things for each and every record you write and record. Now, since even though we sometimes have most of the songs written before we went to the studio and record them, we always do a lot of changes, you know. And especially on the last record, which we wrote and put together in the studio. So it's always like, I can never know how the album will sound like until it's completed. And most of the times it surprised me. The result always surprised me, you know. And but then when I start, you know, listening to all the songs all together, pictures come up, and we, you know, both me and Caligula get ideas from his lyrics and the music. And on the last two records we have had this guy Morbid, Italian artist, and he understands our, you know, our music very well. So I can just give him some ideas what I have in mind for an image. And then I give him free hands, and you know, he sends some images over. I give him some, you know, ideas for changes, you know, and we just pass the ideas back and forth until we're really satisfied. Label-wise, well, I guess you will never be 100% satisfied, but I have a big respect and satisfaction with Regain, because he treat the bands with respect, and it's the way it should be treated, you know, be dealt, you know. From where we come from, you know, there's lots of rip-off people. And well, it's still ongoing with our former label, and it looks like a never-ending fucking nightmare. I think I'm just a very pissed off person. And there's always new things that pisses me off, and I have to get it out somewhere, and I get a good relief by writing the music. I write this music more for myself, and, you know, to be able to live with myself, I guess, and live in this shitty fucking world too. So, but if people can understand what I really have in mind when I write the lyrics, what the melodies really mean and stuff like that, then it's really cool. And there was one journalist in Sweden who, you know, one thing that people maybe misunderstand about our music, but it's the hype from, you know, the media and the record labels. It's like, it's, you know, that we claim that it's the most evil music in the world. We never said it ourselves. Of course, we write very evil music, but it's not the main point about our music. So this journalist, he had totally got it into his head when he put on the new record. Oh yeah, now I'm gonna listen to the most evil record. And so I read his review, and he started writing about that. It's not the most evil record, but I can really understand the pain and everything behind all the melodies, and, you know, he explained all the feelings I got when I listened to it. And I said, fuck, that's got to be one of the first reviews I've read who really fucking understood the music. And he called me and he said, I'm sorry if you got pissed off on my review. And I was like, you got to be kidding. This is the first fucking good review of, you know, the first and only review I've seen that, you know, from a person who understood more than just the evil concept. Well, I'm not much for a festival person, and we don't really like playing festivals. That's why we are not playing many festivals. We do a few, but there's other black metal and death metal bands. They play fucking every festival there is. And to be honest, I don't like playing those huge festivals. It's nice, you know, once in a while, but you know, there's such a stress. You never get a sound check. You got fucking 3 minutes line check and then on, and then you see these people standing with 10 watches and like that you gotta be on time, and if you know, it's just you can't build up a great show that way. And I can't understand how these festival people, what they think about when they put the festival together. I mean, it's gotta be possible for the bands to do a good show, because otherwise the crowd, I mean, it's all for the fans who are there. So of course they want to see a good show, not just something that put together in a hurry. And that's the main thing I don't like about festivals.